heart is a pump that sends a constant supply of fresh blood to every part of our body. It pumps blood around and around in a closed loop of blood vessels that's called our circulatory system. Now, if you were to lay out all the millions of tiny blood vessels in your body end to end, they would measure over 100,000 kilometers. That's more than twice the circumference of planet Earth. Now, in reality, blood is always red. But on a diagram, red blood means blood containing oxygen, and blue blood means blood without oxygen. Now, we have two types of blood vessels. Veins, which bring blood towards the heart, and arteries, which bring blood away from the heart. Think A for away, and you'll never forget. The heart also has four chambers: the left atrium, the left ventricle, the right atrium, and the right ventricle. So, let's follow the path of our blood through the heart to see how it works. The pulmonary veins carry oxygenated blood from the lungs towards the heart. This blood enters the left atrium. Now, an atrium was the word for an entrance hall or a waiting room in an old Roman house. So if you remember that, you'll remember that the blood entering the heart will always go to the atrium first, to wait for a second, before carrying on to the next chamber, which is the left ventricle. Now, there's a clever little one-way valve between the atrium and the ventricle. So once the blood passes to the ventricle, it can't get back to the atrium. When the next heartbeat comes, the blood will instead be squeezed out of the left ventricle and out through the aorta, a massive artery that carries this fresh oxygenated blood all around your body to supply all your muscles and organs. But this artery is actually tiny compared to the artery of a blue whale. They have the largest heart of any mammal. So large, in fact, that a human child could easily fit inside and poke their head out through the aorta. But back to humans. So this is the part where the blood magically turns blue. Once the oxygen has been used up, this blue blood has to go back to the lungs somehow. It travels through your veins, towards the heart, and where do you think it will enter? The right atrium, of course. And on the next heartbeat, it'll be pushed through another one-way valve into the right ventricle before it travels through the pulmonary artery all the way to the lungs to absorb fresh oxygen. And then the whole cycle continues, every second of every day for your whole life, without you even noticing.